Hello guys, welcome once again to my kitchen. Greetings from my kitchen to yours. Thank you everyone for subscribing to my videos, for liking and for the comments. Thank you so much. God richly bless you all. This morning I want us to do braai fish. You can call it bony fish, you can call it grill fish, or you can call it braai fish. It's a popular dish in Cameroon. We all love it. So guys, let's get started. For the bony fish, here I've got two large fishes. I'm using Morocco fish. In English they call it carapau fish, but you can go ahead and use any species of fish of your choice. It will still give you the same results. And for the fish, we are going to be doing also the sauce for the fish, because there is no fish without sauce. Fish without sauce is no fish at all. So guys, for our fish sauce, here I've got some ginger, some garlic, one tomato, onions, bell pepper, I've got some nut cube, I've got what we call African nutmeg, I've got some spring onions and salt. Not forgetting our almighty chili pepper. We'll be using that also for our chili sauce. So the fish also will be eating with some ripe bananas. Yes guys, ripe bananas. These bananas, they are the normal bananas that we buy in the supermarket. There's nothing special about it. It's just that you have to choose the ones which are not very ripe. So I will show us how to do that. And also I've got some carrots which we will use in garnishing our fish. When the time comes, you will see how that is being used. And also I've got some olive oil for the sauce and also for brining the fish. So to begin with the cooking process, first you want to go ahead and thoroughly clean your fish, okay? This is a must, a very important step. You must thoroughly clean your fish. And to do that, since my fishes are too big, I want to go ahead and cut it into two parts because it's too big. Like so. But if you bought the normal sizes, there's no need to cut it. You can just grill it whole as it is. So guys, you go ahead and clean it like so. Take out this thin line, or they call it a vertical line or whatever. I don't know, really know what the name is. But if you know what the name is, please don't hesitate to leave it at the comment section. Because we learn every day. We all learn every day, okay? So you want to clean the fish like so. You must take out this part. It's very important that you take it out. Take it out and then check for scales that may be on the fish. Make sure to remove all the scales. Take out the fin. Okay. This place here also, you need to take it out like this. This is how you take out this part. Be careful not to injure the fish. Okay, you take out this part like this. You don't want anything that is bone to in your mouth when you are eating the fish. You take out this part like this. You have to be very careful so as not to wound yourself. You take out this part like this. Okay. There's always scales in between here, the fish, so you make sure you take it out. Take out all the scales of the fish. Also remove the gills. Like so. So guys, I've cleaned the fish, but it's not yet clean. So just go ahead and give it a cut, just so that when we are cooking this fish, it will cook and all the spices will go inside. Just give it a beautiful cut, like so. Go ahead and give the fish a beautiful cut. You cut it, but not so deep, hey? You don't touch the bone, hey? Just a beautiful cut for your spices to go in. After doing that, guys, take some lemon and put on the fish, like so. Put your lemon on top of the fish. Make sure the lemon goes inside, okay? Put lemon on top of your fish, like so. Put lemon and then you put salt. Put salt. Make sure you put the salt inside your fish. This is the best way to clean your fish before roasting. This salt is going to remove all the blood that water can't take out. And the smell, if you eat this fish, you won't have that after fish smell in your mouth or in your breath, okay? This is an important step. So, you marinate the fish with salt and lemon. Then, you set that aside, okay? And leave it for some time while you go ahead and prepare your fish sauce. So, for our fish spice, you just go ahead and put in your spring onions in the blender. You put in your tomatoes in there. I'm removing the seeds from the tomatoes because usually I don't like my tomato with seeds. Put in your tomato. I'm just putting in one tomato, only one. Put in your njangsa. Jangsa. Put in your ginger. Garlic and fish are friends. Whether bright fish or any other kind of fish you want to cook, make sure you put garlic in it. Garlic and fish are friends. Don't forget your African nutmeg. I'm just putting in one African nutmeg inside, just one, like so. Okay, guys. A little bit of water to blend. You must have noticed that I didn't put in the chili. That is because this sauce, part of it will be for the chili and the other part will be, I will use it like my marinade to marinate the fish while I'm brining it. So I don't put chili before I blend it. I will put it after. You will see. Okay. So you go ahead. Remove some of that. You will use it to marinate your fish. And then you leave some in the blender. The one that is left in the blender, you go ahead. And add your chili in it. Go ahead and add your chili, depending on how hot you want it. Here I'm going to add good quantity of chili so that I can keep some in the fridge for after use. My chili is coming from the deep freezer. That's how I store my chili, so that it can last long. Okay, guys. Yeah. Then you blend that up. Blend it. Our chili is ready. Go ahead and put that inside a pot. This one is a pepper for fish, okay? This one is hot. in here, go ahead and add your salt and add no cube also to taste. Add your salt and no cube to taste. Then you put in your oil. Put in your oil. Put in your oil. And then you put it on the stove. So guys, while we were doing the sauce for the fish, our fish was being marinated. You can see the blood that came out from the fish. You see that? Because of the lemon and the salt that we applied on the fish. So at this stage now, you want to go ahead and clean this fish with a toothbrush. This toothbrush, well, I bought it specifically for the purpose of cleaning my fish. It's not the toothbrush that we use in the bathroom. Okay? Go ahead and thoroughly clean that fish now, making sure to remove everything that you didn't remember to remove. Then you clean inside with that brush. Because the blood that is in this bone, like this, this blood here, it leaves a bitter taste if you don't clean it properly. Okay? You clean it inside. You can see inside. Just do like so with your toothbrush. Okay? You see? This blood is always bitter in the mouth if you don't clean it properly. Clean it properly. You can see that. You use a toothbrush to clean it and make sure you remove everything inside the fish. Everything. Remove everything from the fish. Our fish is nice and clean. Our fish is nice and clean, guys. Just leave it like this for about 10 minutes while you are preparing your spice, and then you start to brine it. The reason why I'm leaving it like this is just so that the water in the fish will drain out. So here is our chili. It's cooking. We just want to cook it until it dries down. Until all the water I used in blending dries down. Then it's fine. You can see our chili is ready. This is the chili for the fish. It's ready. So guys, as you can see, our grill is ready, nice and hot. Our fish also is now dry, ready to fry. Then you need vegetable oil, then your fish spice. In here, remember, we blended it and we kept half for our chili. And here, this one, what you do is you just go ahead and add in some salt and no cube if you prefer. Putting in some salt there for taste. Yes, like so. I'm just going to put salt, but you go ahead and put some no cube for taste in that spice. Then you need this brush and this brush, and you need two sets of knives. You will see me use demonstrate them. So to fry the fish, you go ahead and open the you call this place what, you open the head, put in some spice, put some spice inside as well. You go ahead, just put some oil on the fish. Also, don't forget to put oil on your grill. Then you go ahead and place your fish on it. Repeat the same process. And you just let it cook. So our fish has been cooking now for some time. Let's check it out. You see why I said you needed two knives? Okay, the fish is just put oil before you flip it over. After flipping over, just go ahead and marinate it. The reason you don't marinate it before putting on the grill is because the marinade will get stuck on the grill. And you don't want that. You want a perfectly grilled fish. Marinate it. So I'm just making ready for the second batch. Just repeat the same process. So while the fish is cooking, let's go ahead and prepare our banana to go with it. Just peel it off like that and cut it into thin slices, like so. Banana, we're going to fry this until golden brown. I'll show you how. So now guys, let's do our plantain. So guys, our oil is hot. Let's go ahead and fry it. These are bananas, not plantain. So they'll cook faster. Just like 2 minutes on each side will be fine. So guys, here in a pan, I'm just frying some carrots, onions, and some bell peppers, okay? Just to decorate our fish. You know what they say, you eat with your eyes first before you eat with your mouth, okay? So that's what we want to do, just to decorate our fish. So we're frying carrots. First, put the carrots, then fry it for about 5 minutes. Then you add your onions, and then you add your bell peppers and fry for another 5 minutes. Then you're done, okay? Just to decorate your fish. Like so. So guys, yes, our finished product, our burning fish, grilled roasted fish is ready. Thank you all for watching. If you love what you are seeing, please go ahead, like, comment, share, and subscribe to my channel. Until next time, see you in my next video. Bye-bye.